Hello and welcome to Picture Astrology. In this video, we will look at a very common question which has been asked by many of our astrology friends, and it's a very common occurrence that you have a situation where your, let's say, ascendant is at a very advanced degree. I'm just saying 29 degree, but it could be at any advanced or higher or lower degree, whereas a planet is situated far away from that degree position. So say for example, ascendant is at 29 degrees in the sign of Aries, but the planet is in 1 degree of sign of Aries. And this situation can be reversed also, where ascendant could be at 1 degree, but the planet is at 29 degrees in any sign. And in such cases, you will find that the ascendant is in Aries, but in Bhav chart or the house chart, the planet would have moved to either the 12th Bhav or the 2nd Bhav. And that is only in the Bhav Chalit Kundali or the chart where we look at Bhavas. And the common question is, what happens in such situation? How will the planet give results? How its Dasha or time periods or Mahadasha will give results? And in this situation, essentially there are two boundaries at play. There is one boundary of sign or Rashi, and there is one boundary of Bhav or house. And the key to determining the answers of a lot of these questions is knowing which of these two boundaries is stronger. And in this video, we will try to find out some of the most fundamental rules which you can apply to know which of the boundaries can be stronger and how the result of the planet is going to be in general chart and also during its Dasha and Mahadasha. So let's look at a typical chart. And I'm just taking a North Indian style of chart as I usually do. Now in this chart, you see this boundary which is right here. So this is the first Bhav. Now this first house or first Bhav is showing the house as well as the sign. So typically, to make things easier to interpret, and not just easier to interpret, this also practically works in most situations, is that we say this is the boundary of the first house. This is also the boundary of first sign. So you have first house where the sign of, say, Aries is residing. But now we are going to talk about those edge cases where there could be a lot of difference between these two degrees. Now, first, a very quick look at what exactly we mean by a Bhav or what are the boundaries of these signs and houses. So say this is Earth, and at the time of your birth, you are, say, right here, and sun is rising at this particular point. Now, if you look at in the east direction from the point of your birth, suppose this is the east direction and this constitute the 30 degrees towards the east from the point on Earth where your birth took place. Now, this 30 degree is the first house. And now, suppose we try to draw a line at the center of this, right here. Well, not actually center, what we are drawing line is from this point on Earth to exact east. And this may not coincide exactly with the middle point of this sign. Suppose this point is coming at as 10 degree. I mean, in the picture it doesn't look like it, but assume it's, say, 10 degree, and the center of sun right here, say, it's at 25 degree. So like this example, you will have, say, a sign of Aries rising at 10 degree at the time of birth, but sun is at 25 degree in the sign of Aries. Now let's see. So I just elaborated or drew that picture in a simple box term to understand those two boundaries clearly. So if you see this let's say is the 30 degree boundaries of your house. In a quick caveat, I am taking a very simplistic view of a house being 30 degrees. There are other theories which can have houses with varying degrees other than 30 degree too, but we are not going there. So this is the boundary of 30 degree of your house, but this dotted line is the boundary of the sign or Aries sign, and this is the house. So in case your ascendant point say falls here, and assume in the first house there was sun, and sun was right here, so you are going to have two different degrees of ascendant and sun, but they both will be in the same sign and in the same house. But if say the sign of or the degrees of sun was very early and it was falling say here, now you will have a situation where the ascendant degrees or the ascendant degrees is falling in the sign of Aries, which is the first house, but within the boundary of first house, sun is in the Pisces sign. Or say sun is say somewhere here, then you will have a situation where your ascendant sign is Aries, that is the sign of your first house. Sun is also in Aries, but from the house boundaries, it is falling in the second house, and so on. So now in this situation, what results are you going to get? So let's take one thing first, which is very clear. One thing is, whenever you're looking at aspects, say sun aspect the seventh house or Jupiter aspect fifth house, aspects are mostly in most schools of traditional astrology are taken from sign position only. It doesn't matter even in Bhav chart if it goes to some other house. Aspects, you know, aspecting fifth house, third house is all from the sign position. In the second rule, which I should have said is the first rule, is that whenever such thing happens that a planet changes its position between a Rashi chart and the Bhav chart, then only the Bhav interpretation, how you interpret the Bhav position, that only should change based on Bhav chart. And what I mean by is that say in Rashi chart, sun is in the first house, but in Bhav, say it is in the 12th. Then if you are reading a chart, only when you trying to read Bhav position, you should say sun is in the 12th Bhava or house. But everything else, like when you are looking at conjunction, or aspects, or looking for, you know, things like, oh, something is exalted, or debilitated, or any other thing which you are going to look at, position in the D9 charts or anything, they are mostly, this is the guideline I am saying, which is generally followed, is taken from Rashi position. And only when we are saying, okay, sun is in first house or 12th house, then we say, okay, sun in 12th house. And one of the reason for that is, generally, like I said in the beginning, that it depends between whether the sign boundaries or these house boundaries, which of them are stronger. So generally speaking, the sign boundaries are taken to be stronger, and there are some simple rules also around this. So if you see the symbol or logo of picture astrology, you will see that we highlight these four bhavas specially. And there is a reason to do that. See, bhavas are generally strong when naturally the time of the day represents or coincides with the bhava's time. And that is the, what in Sanskrit is called as Sandhi Kal, or time where day or night meets or time of the day changes. So early morning, when the sunrise is just about to happen, or the evening, or transition from night to really deep night, the midnight. Similarly, the afternoon time when sun is right at the top of your head or at the highest point in the horizon. So during these four times specially is when bhavas get more power or more strength. And this has also been observed in practical astrology, that specifically when the bhavas are, you know, at or time of birth is somewhere close to the sandhi kals, then we should look at bhava chart specifically to see if the position is changing. Now it doesn't happen always, or it doesn't happen with all the planets, but this is one specific rule where bhavas get more strength. And signs, as I said, sign boundaries are generally taken to be in general more stronger, but certain signs, or there are some conditions where sign gets even more stronger, or there is a source of, you know, strength to those. One of the most important one is the sign lord. See, if the sign lord is strong, the sign is strong, and thus the sign boundaries would also be strong. And in this case, specifically, if the ascendant sign lord, the Rashi in which your ascendant point falls, if that sign lord is very strong, then the sign boundaries will even get stronger. In cases where, say, ascendant sign lord is weak, but other sign lords are more stronger, then this is one case where we have to look at the Bhav chart specifically more. But that is the second rule, or that is the second restraint. First, the birth should be at least around the Sandhi Kal. Then there are, in Vedic astrology, you know, there are certain signs who get stronger in day, there are certain signs who get stronger at night, and so on. So those also contribute to the strength of the sign. In this case, we have to again specifically look at the ascendant sign strength, you know, according to the rules, whether it's stronger in day or night or not. And another very small but important thing to note is that a planet becomes lord of a house by virtue of being lord of a sign. A planet is first lord of a sign, and because of that becomes the house lord. It's not the vice versa. Because I always used to have this question as to why sign boundaries are or given more strength, and this is one of the reason, that this is the cause and this is the effect. And in our astrology handbook as well, many times when we come across this kind of situations, you know, many people who have taken this handbook with us would have seen, sometimes we go back and ask this question, when based on some of the rules which we just discussed, we see that the Bhav chart is looking to be more stronger rather than the Rashi chart. And that again specifically happens first with the ascendant. Then we go back and ask the questions to ascertain that as well. But these are some of the rules for knowing which of these boundaries, which of, you know, whether the house boundaries or the sign boundaries are more stronger, and how it affects interpretation of position and dashas. Thank you for watching with me so far. Please do post your views and questions. And thank you for your support so far.